Hey now, Rodney Erdickson here with an important note about Comwave, essentially the telephony provider that is showcased frequently on CBC News Network. Although it would seem that, hey, you know, they got Ty Domi behind their ads and they offer you this great, great full-featured home phone for $15 a month, important to note that Comwave requires the end user to already have high-speed internet and a router. And essentially what Comwave does is Comwave sends you a small little device. And what this does is this connects to your existing router and your existing internet connection. And essentially what it does is, by the way, this was the device I myself received. That device right there, that little box. And essentially what it does is it uses your bandwidth, your high-speed internet modem, your high-speed internet service, and your router in order to function the home phones in your home. Now, some of you may not have a problem with this. Some of you may think, oh, this is just fine and dandy. Unfortunately, there are considerations to take into account before committing to a company like Comwave. You see, the major players such as Bell, well, Bell will install a physical landline, and major players like Videotron in Quebec, for example, if you just order their telephony service, what they will do is they will literally provide you with a cable modem, and your phone will connect through this cable modem, and this cable modem, if you don't have Videotron internet service, will be dedicated to providing your home phone service through the Videotron backbone, through the Videotron servers, if you will. What Comwave does is Comwave relies on, once again, your bandwidth, your existing internet, and your existing router. To some, this doesn't make a big deal. However, in Canada, for the grand majority of the players, we pay for bandwidth. We pay for how much we download a month and how much we upload a month. Some of you may not see this. Maybe you're the type who goes on the internet once a week, goes on Facebook to look at cat pictures. If you are, congratulations. But for those of us who actually, you know, use the internet extensively, streaming videos, downloading, what have you, online gaming, anything that takes up a lot of bandwidth, well, bandwidth becomes a concern. Now, there's two sides to bandwidth. Not only is it possible that you have upload and download caps on your bandwidth, however, if you are one to have a very limited bandwidth or not extremely high speed, now, of course, everybody uses the term high speed. The term high speed is used loosely. But unless you're paying for a premium high speed service, like we're talking a higher megs per second than the standard offering, then what can happen is during the making and receiving of phone calls with a service such as Comwave, well, what happens is this can slow down all of your other internet happenings that are happening at the same time, such as streaming video, such as this one, or playing online games, or what have you, downloading, whatever you have, whatever you're using the internet for. Not only will it slow that down, but your phone calls through a service such as Comwave will become choppy, they'll become latent, they'll become echoey, they'll break up. Essentially, you will not have a constant and consistent telephone conversation as you would with another service. Now, why am I creating this video? I mean, why am I singling out Comwave when so many other providers provide similar services, such as Vonage? Well, to me, Comwave's a tricky beast. You see, Comwave is an internet service provider. Comwave could obviously provide the hardware to connect to Comwave servers through Comwave's backbone, thus using Comwave's internet, thus using Comwave's bandwidth, thus using Comwave's resources. However, they refuse to do this unless you purchase internet from them. So now you'd have to purchase internet plus their home phone. Well, many, many, many ISPs offer this option. This is not exclusive to Comwave. The thing with Comwave is Comwave just has the budget to have this marketing campaign with Ty Domi and get their name out there so often that you associate it as the third major, well, at least in Quebec, the third major player behind Bell and Videotron. Sadly, when it comes down to it, there's all those considerations to take into play. Yes, they're around $16 a month, and you have all those features. However, you're still working off of your internet, your bandwidth, your router. And now, not to mention, you're relying on two different services. You're relying on the Comwave service being up and running, and you're relying on your own internet to be up and running. If one of those two go down, well, then you have no home phone. To me, it was the offering was just simply disappointing. I mean, like I said, for some it might be just fine and dandy. I should mention that the only thing that Comwave is really offering here for $16 a month is the ability to connect your home phones, your existing landline-type phones, to your internet. Whereas with online services such as freephoneline.ca, smartphone apps such as Fongo and Groove IP Lite, plugins and extensions such as Gmail's Call Phone, all of these services are generally provided free online without the need to pay $16 a month. Of course, what this requires is that you use either your computer or your smartphone as the household phone. That's where things get a little tricky, of course. Some people just want to have multiple phones in their house. They want to have the home phone experience instead of having to go through smartphones or having a computer running all day. I understand. Just you have to evaluate if this is worth $16 a month. Like I said, here in Quebec, Videotron telephony service is obviously an alternative to the very expensive Bell landline phone. And their offering certainly isn't as advantageous as Comwave. It's around $25 a month for basic phone with no features. However, like I mentioned, they provide you with all the hardware and you're running off of Videotron's backbone and not your pre-existing internet. Not to mention that you don't have to have internet through Videotron in order to receive Videotron home phone. Also important to note, through Comwave, yes, $16 a month, but you actually have to buy this little device. It comes up to around $70. This little box that plugs into your existing router, taking up a port on your router in order to use up your bandwidth to provide you with the home phone service. Well, there you go. I hope this clarifies things for certain people. I don't know if this information was of any use to people interested in Comwave. I know when I learned of how Comwave worked and how they didn't provide hardware to connect to their backbone, this turned me off, so I figured there has to be other people like me who would benefit from this information. Well, there you go, I'll leave it at that. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.